Welcome to Between the Whistles, Detroit. Obviously, today we have some big breaking news from the Detroit Red Wings. Philip Hronek was dealt in a deal where the Detroit Red Wings are getting a first-round pick this year that is protected in the top 12 and a second-round pick for Philip Hronek. Now, Philip Hronek having a great season. Obviously, he's doing really, really well this year. Defensively, he's been an absolute albatross, but offensively, he has really put the puck in the net, been a significant point getter for the Detroit Red Wings. But Stevie Y deals him for a first round pick and a second round pick to a team that's not even contending for anything. And yeah, he does have some term left on his deal. You know, he's a restricted free agent after next year. Just a total fleece job by Stevie Y. Absolute fleece job. What he just did is exactly what he's doing. Now, here's what I have to say about this. Because Stevie Y made this move, I'm expecting a bigger move. And if it doesn't come by the trade deadline, I expect it in the summer, where I don't think the Red Wings will have those draft picks. I think he's going to use those draft picks to trade for a winger or get someone in a substantial return in a trade. I don't think that Stevie Y is going to even use these picks, but it's just an unreal return for a guy that, let's be honest, I don't think he fits in this team's plans moving forward. I mean, I know people thought that he fit in the plans, but you look at the logjam of good defenseman prospects they got in this organization. You know, you got Wallander, you got Evanson, you got Sabrango. There's some good players that are coming up the pike, and I think that if Philip Hronek, listen, he was the odd man out. Ole Mata is playing pretty well. They're locked into a deal with Ben Chiarot. Jake Walman just got extended. Sider is obviously going to be a fixture on that line, but what a great trade by Stevie Y today, making the best out of probably, I was just surprised that he made that move, and I'm surprised that he got the return he got. Just an absolute steal for Stevie Y, and I'm convinced that Stevie Y drugs other GMs before he makes a trade, because he always gets better. You look at the Nick Leddy trade last year, he got Jake Walman, Oscar Sundquist, and a second round pick that we're going to use this year. Billy Huso for a third round pick. I mean, this guy continues to make trades and just absolutely demolish these guys in the trade department. He obviously wins every trade that he's made so far. I really don't see a trade that he hasn't made that didn't end up in a good situation. Maybe the Washington deal. But you look at the Washington deal, they got a first-round pick in Sebastian Coates as part of that. And I think Sebastian Coates got a very, very bright future in Detroit. So what a deal by Stevie Y. What a freaking move. And it sets the Detroit Red Wings up for some fireworks coming up soon.